where people, participate, young people participate, and of course their parents and other people also very interested in sports, as you can see from the latest Olympics. And the other areas that we look at are things like music and arts. And so these are two areas that we've been supporting for a long time, and we will continue to support. So from that perspective, we felt that tennis is a good place for us to focus our energies, and we've been looking at tennis and supporting tennis in some way from a corporate perspective to the extent that we can. And we started out with tennis in last year, in 2015. We did a city tournament in Delhi, wherein we called children from various schools in Delhi and did a tournament. It was super, pretty successful. We followed it up with one in Chennai in February again this year, the beginning of this year. And that was again very successful. So we had over 500 participants across these two tournaments from over 130 schools. So then the idea was born that that's fine, that is a city level. Why don't we look at this as a national thing we could do for the sport, along with AITA, along with our partners, Mahesh Bhupati Tennis Academies, and create something which is like a part of the tennis calendar of young people. So that is the hope, and that's what we want to do right now. And that's why we are sort of building this this tournament here. And the broad details, of course, again, my colleague Gaurav, who's will talk about how exactly we're looking at this and what the key points are. But broadly, this is the tournament that we're doing is for children age under 12 and under 14. There are both boys and girls. These will be done across four cities in India. We looked at various zones. So Chennai is the south zone. Then there is Calcutta in the north, in the east zone. We looked at Pune for the west zone and Lucknow for the north zone. So these are the four cities where we do this tournament. We start off in Chennai. Chennai is the first kickoff. We'll start off on 27. And it's a week-long tournament, after which we will come out with what I call the winners. Now, from the winners, we will then do what I call, across these four places, one final tournament in Delhi, in the city of Delhi, wherein the winners of this tournament come together, and then they will participate in the final 16 for the final rank. But the first four tournaments are eligible for IATA rankings, and so many students and many players of the game can actually come and actually get what I call their rankings as part of the stuff that they do here. And so we have seen, I think, quite a lot of interest in this tournament, and that some of those details I will
relation with tennis. So the whole idea here is to tap talent at a young age, under 12 and under 14. In India, if you see, when I was playing, there used to be a lot of tournaments in under 10, under 12 and under 14. And that is where the kids used to get a lot of chance to compete and to learn how to handle victory and defeat and success and failure. Of late, we believe that there's not too many tournaments in India at the under 12 and under 14 stage, which is such a formative stage for the kids to actually pick up good or bad habits. So this junior tour is formed keeping that in mind, is to look at how we can tap the talent at the age of under 12 and under 14, and which is why what we've done is we've worked closely with HCL to do one tournament each in four zones, and the top 14 players would be selected for the Masters, which will be held in Greater Noida at their facility. And what we've also done uniquely is have what is known as a plate event, where the players who actually lose in the qualifying round, they also get a chance to play more matches. A lot of times what happens is parents are traveling with their kids from far away cities to come and play tournaments, and then when you lose in the first round or you lose in the qualifying, it can get very demotivating. So to get the children to play more matches, we thought that we should do this, and I think that the response has been tremendous, because a lot of parents have actually reached out to us and told us how happy they are that even if their kids come, they know that even if the kid loses in the first round, which unfortunately happens to most of the kids in the draw, if it's a draw of 64, 32 kids will lose in the first round, but the kids will then get to play more matches. I think from MBTS perspective, we've always looked at grassroots, focus on grassroots. And I think now, thanks to HCL, we are looking at actually, doing more tournaments to actually look at those grassroots kids who've now reached a certain level, to actually look at you know, going ahead and, you know, representing their state, then national, and then international, and, you know, hopefully, you know, at the next Olympics, or at, you know, for Davis Cup and for other tournaments across the world.
Right, so that was
over the last couple of months, a lot of the top players who've been wanting to get ready for the clay court circuit or the hard court circuit in the US have gone and practiced there. I mean, you know, Andy Murray and a whole bunch of top 100 players were there. So the idea of sending the kids there, and we did this last time as well, is for the child to see and to get exposed at that age to the kind of facilities, to the kind of practice sessions, to the kind of training that happens abroad. Again, just when, you know, when I was playing and when we were all playing, our first trip abroad or the first two or three trips overseas to play tournaments, we used to always have a sense of, you know, seeing all these other kids, you know, dressed out fancily, having the best of equipment, having foreign coaches, traveling with them and things like that. You know, before we stepped on court, a lot of times the match was lost in our head because we felt, you know, they have so much and we hardly have anything. So what we aim to do here is to send the kids there so that they start getting exposed to this and realizing that what they're doing today is perhaps not enough or hopefully inadequate in terms of their training and in their practice sessions and the kind of hard work and the work ethic that they need to put in.
So it's a fully paid up 1 week at the academy. We obviously do spoke to them and all expenses paid and all that. I don't know what about the money value. Honestly, this is not about the money value. It's about the fact that you want to give somebody exposure. Obviously, you're going to, it's a sizable amount of money, but that's not the important point. The important point is that these kids will actually go and be able to experience, as Kaurav mentioned, how it is to play an international circuit. And we hope that will, and we'll continue to do this year after year. So we hope that as more and more people go, they'll get this, how does one say, the desire to perform at international level rather than just at national or local level. That's the thinking behind why we're doing this. Otherwise, there's no reason for us to do an international, for them to go internationally.